everyone. Before we begin the proceedings, I request everyone to put their cell phones on silent. Thank you. My name is Ajay Kumar. I'm a PGP 2 student. I feel immense pleasure in extending a very warm welcome to our chief guest today, Dr. P. Tamilvanan, who's the chairman of New Mangalore Port Trust. Our respected faculty members, members of the press, and my student colleagues to the inaugural program of PGDM and PGDM Healthcare 2013-2015 batch at TAPMI Management Institute. On behalf of the TAPMI fraternity, I also extend a warm welcome to the parents of the 2013-2015 batch of PGDM and PGDM Healthcare. I now invite Professor Prashant Yadgiri, Chairman PGP, to welcome the audience.
A warm welcome to the dignitaries on the dais, the deans, faculty, staff, parents of the incoming batch, PGP2 students, and the most important focus, the students of the 30th batch of the PGDM and the 4th batch of the PGDM Healthcare. It's really nice to see all students in the morning, eager, enthusiastic, and excited to get going on the new journey. The management program has been always a tremendous learning experience, not just from the classrooms, but also outside the classrooms. It's a course where your classmates help you learn. Of course, I think in your batch, you have classmates with status from 20 different states, 90 different cities, average experience of 2.5 years, 91% of students with engineering experience, or engineering degree, sorry. All this will go a long way in leveraging a lot of experience and knowledge from each other. This also ensures that you learn a lot from different cultures being together, learn a lot of different behaviors being together. You also learn the way business is done in different states being together, and of course, food habits when you meet in the canteen. And such insights can definitely be more helpful in your career later, if not now. But it requires all of you to get out of your comfort zones, meet new people, attend all activities in the institution, get to know a new person every day in the classroom. It takes roughly a year if you want to do that. And all this also again helps you to build a good network of friends in years to come. And most importantly, you develop as a great person again in days to come. The management program will involve a significant amount of academic rigor, especially at TAPMI, we are known for that. And soon you will realize that your time is not your time. You will soon be juggling between different priorities, not just different, multiple priorities, both on the personal front and work front. And hence, again, you'll start learning to find out how best I can make use of each minute of mine. This batch of PGDM 2013-15 has a total of 415 candidates with 30% representation from the gender girls, roughly 126 numbers, 91% representation by engineers, and other degrees which also include science, arts, and others. I'm very sure all of you are very excited to start this journey. Welcome once again to the TAPMI Management Institution, very popularly known as TAPMI across the world. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I now request everyone to rise for the invocation song.
Mahaganapatim manasa smarami, Mahaganapatim manasa smarami, Mahaganapatim. Mahadevasutam, Mahadevasutam, Guru Gohanutam, Mahadevasutam, Guru Gohanutam, Marakoti Prakasam Santam, Mahakavyanatakadi Priyam, Mahakavyanatakadi Priyam, Mushika Vahanamodaka Priyam, Mahaganapatim Manasa Smarami, Mahaganapatim.
I now call upon our chief guest, and with that, I also request our director, Dr. R.C. Natarajan, Dr. A. Shantaram, trustee and member, Governing Council, TAPMI. And with that, I also request our Dean Administration, Professor Raghunath Rudran, and Dean Academics, Professor Guru Rajkatiu, to inaugurate the ceremony by lighting the lamp. I now request our director, Dr. R.C. Natarajan, to extend a floral welcome to our chief guest. I request our director, sir, to extend a floral welcome to Dr. S. Shantaram, trustee and member, Governing Council, TAPMI. Thank you, sir. I now invite our director, Dr. R.C. Natarajan, for the welcome address.
That gives you an idea of what you have in store in TAPMI for the next 2 years. Good morning. The difference between ending up as yet another Me Too MBA and reaching very great heights in career and in life depends entirely on what you're going to do for the next 2 years here. We provide you the facilities for you to make best use of. We give you all the support. But we will not be spoon-feeding you. The fundamental belief in TAPMI is that students who join us are adults, and you will have enough opportunities to prove us wrong. Whether you want to prove us wrong or you want to prove us right is going to be dependent on you. The faculty members will not teach anything. They'll be facilitators. The learning has to come from you. In the process, the faculty will learn. So it's an entirely learning and student-centric institution. However, we do not treat you as our customers. If I were to use any analogy about how we treat you, pardon me for saying so, you are raw materials. But not in an assembly line, but in the hands of various artisans. You are free to talk to all the faculty members whenever you want. Of course, fix up an appointment because they have other prior commitments possibly. But nobody is going to say no to you. There is freedom and there are restrictions. The freedom is to enjoy, experiment the right things. The restrictions are just to make you realize or understand that there are also others in the institution whose rights, space and welfare that are to be respected. So you will have to balance between these two throughout your 2 year career. The default response to any request, if you have any doubt, you may check with Nikshep, who is standing there, who is the president of your students' executive council. The default response to any request will be a no. The idea is you have to have the conviction within yourself and the courage and the character to put it across in a manner that converts that no into a yes. It's a part of the learning process. The institute is known for its discipline orientation. We know the difference between being discipline oriented and regimentation. Many a time you will get the feeling that things are being regimentalistic. It's a matter of interpretation. But if you step back and see, you'll see a lot of freedom, and you'll also see the overall purpose for which these restrictions are there. As Dr. Prashant Yadigiri said, you will have to balance between various facets of your priorities, personal, family, academic, and certain other relational aspects. How you prepare yourself emotionally and mature into a total human being is what the two-year learning is all about. The classroom learning, the subjects, the tools and techniques, the textbooks, the notes, all these will be there. But in addition, it's not instead, but in addition to all this is how you learn to manage your own emotions, how you learn to communicate. You're all people from different parts of this country. There are lots of cultural diversities that you will be encountering. For example, for some people this means yes. For some people this means yes. For some people it means yes, I'm listening. Simple example. So you don't know what the other person is thinking actually. Starting from this to the manner in which they speak, the food habits, the habit of staying late in the night studying, I'm assuming of course, or perhaps listening to music, or reading a textbook, reading a storybook. And if you have the good luck of being a roommate to that person and you are an early sleeper, good things are happening to you to adjust. So how you adjust yourselves, how you rub shoulders with people from different places with different personality types, all these things are what you're going to face the challenges on the next 2 years. Most of the challenges will come from within yourselves, first individually and then among the students. And we faculty members are there to add as catalysts more and more challenges. And in March 2015, when you look back, you can smile and say, I've crossed all that. Wow. Welcome to TAPMI. Wish you all the best.
Thank you, sir. It's a pleasure to have Dr. P. Tamilvanan with us today. He completed his post-graduation in economics from PST College of Arts and Science, Coimbatore, and holds the master's degree in business administration from Madras University. He completed his doctoral degree in economics from Bharatiya University, Coimbatore. He started his career as an officer in Hindustan Shipyards, Vishakhapatnam, and served in Chennai Port Trust, Cochin Port Trust, and Vishakhapatnam Port Trust in various capacities. During his tenure in those ports, he made many progressive changes in port operation, labor management, and obtained ISO 14001 and ISO 18001. His interest in marketing is much appreciated in trade and port sector. He joined New Mangalore Port Trust as chairman on 10th December 2004. He is responsible for construction of new berths, improvements to road network, port railways, computerization, campus networking, and other IT network for systematic and transparent port operation, introduction of closed circuit television cameras, development of green belt, biometric system for labor booking, ISO 14001-2004, EMS certification, etc. New Mangalore Port Trust during the current financial year, which is 2012-13, handled a record traffic of 37.04 million tons of cargo, registering a growth of 12.43% over the last year's traffic. Container traffic raised from 9,600 in 2005 to 48,409 in 2013. We welcome you to TAPMI, sir. I now request our chief guest to speak to our audience.
Good morning, friends. Dr. Rajan, the director, Dr. Shantaram, deans, faculties, the beaming students, and their parents, and my dear friends. The moment I entered the hall, I felt I become young. On seeing the young spirit around here, the beautiful faces of youngsters, I really felt a thing of beauty is a joy forever, because in a port, I cannot see such things. Maybe a ship, maybe a package, or and different kind of things. It's so heartening to hear the introduction and the welcome address by the faculty as well as the director. At the outset, I feel I'm in a place where a great statesman of the country, by stature and nature, the respectable Shri.P institution here. In fact, every day when I represent, every time I represent a port to the audience, maybe Indians and abroad, one slide is a permanent slide of the port within first two, three slides. That is the inauguration of the New Mangalore Port in the 1975, which was inaugurated by Mrs. Gandhi, and next to him was sitting the real statesman, Shri.P. We take it upright with all those hard work, well wishes, like people like him, Srinivas Malaya and Shri.P. The port is growing very well in the years. Shri.P. never bothered about one thing. As a real statesman, he concerned about the overall growth of the economy. He put his endeavor, efforts in banking, in education, and hospital. For a country, the largest populated next only to China country, these things are very vital. With his own effort, he started these institutions. Now it has become world-renowned institutions of the country. In fact, I was reading the paper this morning Hindu. It says, the United Nations report says regarding population, now the population of India is 120 crores, but in the year 2028, it will be more than China. China is today 136. In 2028, the population of India, they say, will surpass China. So for that population, basic facilities are required. A health is required, and Manipal, no doubt, one of the very, very prestigious institute of the world, I can say. So also the banking, Syndicate Bank, it was founded by Shri.P. and it sets an example for its efficiency. So also the education institutions, I think, now when we call, say, Manipal, the thing immediately which comes to our mind is Manipal, this institute, your own institute. So with this background, I have to congratulate you because you have